Hello, Vivekians. Welcome to your next class of School from Home. I'm your English teacher, Gaganpreet, and today we are going to start with writing section. I hope you all know what is diary writing. Some of you might be having your own personal diaries and some of you might not be having. So today, we'll learn more about diary writing. That what is diary writing? How do we write it? Okay, we'll learn a lot about it today. So I hope you're all ready to learn about the beautiful skills of diary writing. So students, first of all, what is diary writing? A diary is a kind of personal journal in which you record your day-to-day experiences and incidents and how they affect you personally and emotionally. So it is something really personal to a person, okay? You can express your opinions, your reactions, and how you feel about everything that is going around you and elsewhere in the world. But there's a small question, that what kind of language should we use in a diary entry? So students, since it is your personal journal, it is something personal to you. So, it is all about what you feel. So, the language you employ should be personal and informal. However, you should not use negative comments, okay, and expressions that shouldn't be used in a children's diary. You should, even though it's your personal, but you should use a proper, decent language. Although informal, but a good one, okay. Also, preferably, we write diary in first person. First person means I. So, because you're telling your experiences, you write it in first person. Now, the next question that most of us have in our mind is, how long a diary entry should be? So, generally, this question comes in the mind of students that, ma'am, how long do we have to write? So, students, in real life, a diary entry can be anything. From a single line to several paragraphs, even a few pages long. But in an examination situation, a question or diary on diary entry does have a definite word limit. So when we are writing it for a school exam or any other examination, there is a word limit in that. And if you're writing a diary entry for the exam, you should respect that word limit. But in real life, when you're writing your own personal diary, you can write it the way you want. You can write it in a paragraph or many pages or just few lines a day. It is up to you. And whenever you're writing diary entry from the examination point of view or you're writing for the school work, then you have to just write a single paragraph. Okay? I hope this much is clear to you. Now, let's begin with a very important point. That what is the layout and format of diary entry? So whenever we are writing anything from the examination point of view, the format and layout is a must and it should be very appropriate. So now we'll start with that. So students, a diary entry usually includes the date, place and time of writing the diary at the top. And then we can describe whatever we want to describe, followed by the name or the signature. Okay. If you like, you can include some suitable heading or title so that you can remember that this diary was about this incident. But that is a choice. Okay. Heading or title is a choice. Rest, it is mandatory. So let's begin with the layout. See, in the first, there are two layouts, first of all. First one is, you will write date, day and time on the leftmost corner, followed by the salutation. Salutation means dear diary, or you can say hi, or you can give some specific name to your diary if it is very personal, close one to you, like dear kitty. But in the examination, you should prefer dear diary. After that, if you want, you can include a suitable title or heading, followed by which you will start with the content or the body part, which includes all the ideas that you want to express. Once you're finished with your content, then on the leftmost side, you'll write the leave taking. Leave taking means bye or phrase like see you, good night, something like that. And at last, your name. Students, since diary entry is something informal, so you don't have to write your complete name. Just write your initial name. For example, my name is Gaganpreet. So I will not write Gaganpreet. I'll just write Gagan. Okay? And in that way, you'll carry out the diary entry. Now, in the second format, you can write day and date on the leftmost corner and time on the rightmost corner. Okay? Both these formats are completely okay. You can follow any one of them. And the rest of the format will remain same. Okay? So students, now we know the format. Now next part is how to build up the content. What preparation do we need to do before writing a diary? For this, I would like to suggest you that whenever you're getting any question for diary entry, just think about that question. Then frame some set of questions that you will answer. Okay? For example, first we should begin with how was the day? Then how are you feeling? What did you learn today? What was your experience? Whom did you meet? What happened at school or what happened at home? Then what is going on in the neighborhood? What lesson did you learn from the experiences today? Okay, so some sort of questions like that. For example, you can begin like this. That dear diary, today was a very tiring day. I am completely exhausted. Tomorrow is my social science exam. And today I had to work really hard so that I can do good in tomorrow's exam. Then you can add up something to that. You know, my friend came to my house in the afternoon because he too was scared for the exam. Then we sat together and prepared. So you can build up like this. When you have some set of questions in your mind, then it is easier to frame the answers and it forms a complete paragraph. Okay? Now, when we are writing our own personal diary, it can be unique. It can be imaginative. It can be poetic. We can even decorate it with sketches, doodles, stickers, photos, newspaper cuttings, and a lot of ideas. But whenever we are writing for the examination, it should be very neat. Nothing should be extra. It should be a bit formal in its appearance. Not in the words, but its appearance. Okay? I hope you understood that how to write an effective diary. And I hope that whenever I'll get to see your notebooks, your diary entries would be amazing. So students, you'll be getting a question in your assignment. Attempt it neatly in your BBC.